I now have over 1,000 hours on this printer. And I'll just go over a few things that I've had to do in terms of maintenance or replacement. Not very many, actually. I believe this is the third time filament has decided it doesn't want to come out of this nozzle, and the extruder starts clicking. And from past experience, I've found it's easiest to remove this so you can see everything that's going on here, and makes it easier to determine what the problem is. This thing needs to be taken apart and put back together again with this at operating temperature. You have to be a little bit careful when you heat this thing up. You no longer have the fan blowing across the heatsink to control the temperature. Turn on the control box, and I adjust the temperature to 200 degrees, 210. I'm going to have a glove on, and I adjust a crescent wrench to fit on here. And when that comes up to temperature, I take another wrench to loosen this. Screw it out with the wrench or with a pair of needle nose. Take that piece while it's still hot. You can reach inside here, grab a piece of that filament and pull it out. The piece of filament that comes out of there is that long. This is now open through here, and you can look up inside there and you'll see some more filament. Every time you change color, it seems to always leave a section of filament in this transition area and butts up against where the end of the nozzle is. So with that open and this at temperature, I take another piece of filament and I shove it through there, and it will push out the bit of filament that's still stuck in there. And you pull that other piece out of there straight away. That should then be clear all the way through there. And you hold this up to a light and you should be able to see that the orifice is clear on your nozzle. Not really sure what causes this to decide to quit extruding. I get the impression occasionally there's a bit of hard material that's in the filament. One of these came with the printer. It's a nozzle cleaning tool. And you can stick that up inside there. Just stick that in the end of that nozzle when this is hot. And you can work that up in there. That will get things going again. Spares are available for this cleaning wire. I'll list that in the description. Spare nozzles are available. I'm still working on the first two nozzles. That's 1,000 hours that's on there. When you get those pieces out of there, while this is still hot, put your wrench back on here. You want to be real careful of these wires that lead up to the thermistor and to your heater. You'll end up with some filament that's on the threads of this nozzle. If this is not up to temperature, you're not going to be able to screw this in, and you do not want to force it. All you have to do while this is hot is just get that started and let it sit there for a minute. Then you can screw it in with your wrench. It'll heat that filament up and you'll be able to screw that in there. And while this is hot, you want to make that tight. Don't try to break it. Just make sure it's good and tight. Apparently they didn't tighten this as much as they could have at the factory, and I had some filament that was leaking out around this transition area on this tube. You got to loosen this screw. I loosened up both of these and then re-tightened them. And tighten this again, and I have not had that leak since I've tightened it. I no longer have that piece of cotton type insulation on here. I'm using a silicone boot that just snaps right on there. I'll list the part number for that in the description. That keeps filament from sticking to the surface of the hot end down here, and it also serves as insulation. At least it seems to be good enough. You want to be careful when you're running this with your control box. These fans are sitting over here. One of them will be running, and it's pretty easy to damage the blades. I've had to replace this one due to my own carelessness. I sheared off some fan blades with a screwdriver. It's not a bad idea to take this apart about once a month and blow the dust out of here, and you will accumulate little thread-like pieces of filament that'll get tangled up in here. You can very gently reach in here with a needle nose. Pull those little hair-like pieces out of there. It's a good time to clean the wheels. You could run this back and forth and just hold a paper towel against it and clean those off. Down here and do the same thing. Over here on the Z-axis, clean these wheels. Surprisingly, these over here stay pretty clean. Wipe out this track, top and bottom where the wheels run, up and down for the Z-axis. I have a can of compressed gas like you use on your computer. Anything that's been accumulating in there, you can blow that out. I'm on my original heating element. It's not a bad idea to have a spare one. They don't cost very much, and if you have one burn out, you don't have a replacement. You'll be sitting around waiting for it for quite a while. You get a pack of two heating elements. I'll put the part number in the description. And you can get a bag of thermistors. The same thermistor is used on the hot end and on the bed heater. I've had to replace the thermistor on the hot end. And I thought I had a problem with the thermistor on the bed heater. You can take these leveling adjustment wheels off on the four corners and take this heating plate out of here and turn it over, and there will be this aluminum-faced insulation that's glued to the bottom of that plate. That's with a self-adhesive material. You can heat that with a heat gun or a hairdryer, and if you're real careful, you can peel that off the build plate and maybe you can reuse that. You can buy a package of spare ones of these that make it a lot easier. Put a new one on there. The thermistor for this bed heater is right here in the center. You have to take that insulation off of there to get to it. When you turn on your control box, you want to look at the temperature reading for the hot end and for the build plate before you turn on any heat. They should both be indicating room temperature. I was getting some air readings and some strange temperatures for this build plate, so I thought the thermistor was bad. Turns out the connection on this four-prong plug was not very good. When I turned on the unit and it was trying to heat up the bed, I noticed that this plug was getting very hot, and it should not be getting hot. I determined that the connection between these four pins and this plug were a bit too loose. These pins are all slotted. You can take a jeweler's screwdriver, very, very slightly stick that in those slots, and that will expand that just a little bit. You'll get a good solid connection, and that solved the problem. Expanding those prongs on the plug fixed the problem on this, but I'd already pretty well torn up the insulation on the underneath side of this bed. And you do need insulation under here to keep this thing up to temperature. Not a bad idea to have a few of these sitting around. They're not terribly expensive, but if you need one and you don't have it, you'll be sitting there for a couple of weeks waiting for it to show up. One other alternative is to buy a complete replacement hot end unit. This is the hot end, thermistor, the heating element, and it's ready to bolt on here.